So consider these sets, and we want to know, we want to find these things. Now, in order to talk about these things, we're going to need to understand what they are. So first off, this symbol here, this U-shaped symbol, is the symbol for a union. So the idea of a union is that it combines two things together. So the union of sets A and B will take everything from A and combine it with everything from B. So we will have the red, green, and blue from set A, and we'll combine that with everything from set B. Now, we already have red, so we don't need to list it twice. And there is the union of sets A and B. Again, the idea behind unions is sort of in a visual form. If this is the set A and this is the set B, we're talking about everything that's contained in either set here. We want everything. There happens to be some overlap here with the word red, but we want everything, so we're unioning or combining these two sets together. All right, and then our second symbol here, this one, is the symbol for an intersection. And just like where two roads cross, the intersection is the part that they share. The intersection of two sets are the elements that exist in both sets. So this is where the two sets overlap. Again, in our visual form, if here's the set A and here's the set B, this time we're interested in this, the part that is in both sets. In this case, the intersection of A and B, the only element that is in both sets is red. And so that is the extent of A intersect B. Now for the third one here, we need to talk about this symbol. When we write A with the little c here, the little c means complement, which is another way of sort of saying the opposite of. Or everything else. So A complement means everything that's not in A. Now sometimes we have sort of a universal set which defines everything that we're talking about, and we'll see an example of that in a second. But in this case, we just have A complement. So we think of this as not in A. So we're looking for everything that's not in A that intersects with C. So from a, again, visual point of view, we're looking for everything that's not in A, right? So outside of A, but that intersects with or is also in C. So it needs to be inside C, but not inside A. So we're looking for this stuff here. We're looking for the stuff that's not in A, but is in C. So C is the list of all these colors here. We want the ones that are not in A. So we don't want red, we don't want green, we don't want blue. We just want the other ones. So that would be orange, yellow, and purple. Now, as I mentioned, it's sometimes we have a universal set defined. So in this case, the universal set, in other words, everything that we're talking about is the set of numbers from 1 to 9. In that case, we can talk about the complement all by itself. So if A is the set 1, 2, 4, then A complement would be everything that's in the universal set that's not in set A. And so that would be the numbers 3, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. That's everything that's not in A, but that is part of the universal set.